for Christ and through Christ, not just through the Son of God, the eternal Son of God, the second person, but through the humanity of Jesus Christ. The entire world was created for the humanity of Jesus Christ. Therefore, the cause of that instrumentality of his sacred humanity must have been present at the very creation. If you understand what that means, that the entire creation was made for the humanity of Christ, the sacred humanity of Christ joined to his divinity. And therefore, the cause, where did Jesus come from? His mother. And so his mother, not consciously, but she was present in a way that her form, that Mary's feminine form, was in the mind of Creator when he created all of this. A mystic said it this way: the sky is blue, the sea is blue for Mary. Because God had her in mind when he was creating things. And what that says to me, and what that should say to us, is that you are a greater sign in giving Christ to the world than you are ever going to be aware of, like Our Lady. You are a greater sign of God's creating power in the world when you stand there in the middle of a blizzard in front of an abortion clinic and say, I'm going to stand firm, just like Mary did not. St. Pius X said, stabat mater. Now these illustrations of Mary, however beautiful these paintings may be, she was standing. And little St. John was saying, it's okay, Johnny, you'll be all right. She was the one who was courageous and stood there. And we are the ones who have to be courageous in this work that we are in of bringing Christ to the world, to this secular order. You have to have a lot of courage. And you have to have a lot of wisdom. And you have to have an understanding that God is going to make you a sign much farther beyond what you would ever think of. We know that of also Our Lady in her geographical devotion. It's Pope John Paul, he said in that wonderful encyclical about the Mother of God, Redemptoris Mater, he said there's a whole geographical devotion to the Mother of God in all these countries, all these different places where God uses these different signs, these apparitions, where God speaks to particular peoples through particular images. That he speaks to us and gives us a word. He gives to us a dialogue, a message of salvation. I just want to share with you something that happened with my vocation, because I think it's very inspiring. It goes much farther beyond anything I could ever imagine to be. I was a little hanyak, as my mother called me, a little pagan when I was a teenager. And called me a lot of things, a little hellion or whatever. I was a little troublemaker. I was the kid in the village, but I said, don't go with him, you'll get in trouble. And so what happened is my mother went to Russia, to Moscow. She went to Czestochowa. She went to Krakow. She went to Rome. She went to Paris with 1,000 pilgrims in 2 747 jets. It was a 101 pilgrimage, and they landed in Russia, and they had the image of Our Lady of Fatima, and they crowned the crown with the bullet in it of Pope John Paul. They crowned it in Moscow, Red Square. They crowned it there, Mary Queen of Russia. Wow. And right after that, my mother says to this priest, hey, my boy is in trouble. What am I going to do about it? She's in Red Square. He says, don't worry, give him to the Mother of God. So my mother kneels down there in this hotel in Red Square, all these people walking by, and he says, I consecrate you, Samuel Medley, and my mother is a proxy. I consecrate you forever, now and forever, to Jesus through the loving hands of Mary. Actually, what he said was, to the Sacred Heart of Jesus through the Immaculate Heart of Mary, with all the protection of the angels and saints.
Wow.
Okay, fine. 3 years later, the very same date, I'm sitting there on the couch, and what happens? God speaks and says, you know, I ask God, what do you want me to do with my life? And he said very, very clearly, priesthood. This is after a whole drama of getting out of the wild state. But what I'm saying is, God called me to priesthood on the very same anniversary of my mother consecrating Red Square. But 1 year after that, I started learning Russian for no apparent reason. And 14 years after that, I met a Russian bishop who said, you don't have a Russian accent when you speak Russian. The Mother of God loves you and she's calling you to Russia. And so my mother said to me, I was so stupid. I should have gone to Minnesota and consecrated to Our Lady of Minnesota. You're going off to Russia. know? And what I'm saying is, you know, each one of us has a story like that where the Mother of God looks at you and chooses you. She picks you out of the basket of fruit and picks you up. And she says, I want this one. And she chooses each one of you by name. The Mother of God, not just God chooses you, but Mary chooses you for a specific purpose. And we have to be aware of that. That's what Chester Hall reminds us of. Because I don't know about you, but I can't stop thinking about Blessed Pope John Paul being chosen by the Mother of God here as a teenager to become something much greater than he could ever imagine himself being. And we are here, these tiny little Goliaths in this culture of death. These tiny little Davids facing this Goliath. Excuse me. Life, this big culture of death, and with these tiny little Davids holding this little rosary sling. Come on, God, let's go. You know, saying that we're going to slay the big ugly foe of God. And we have to have that courage. And so God's brought us to Chestahova to give us that confidence and the courage that he has chosen us. And the Mother of God has chosen us that we be a sign much greater than we ever thought imaginable. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.